In this session, we are going to discuss shift and reduce parser. It is one of the very simple parser, and this particular shift and reduce parser will get implemented here using one stack. So now, a convenient way to implement a shift reduce parser is to use a stack and an input buffer. So one stack will be there and one input buffer will be there. Input buffer will be holding the string which has to be parsed. You know that whenever a string will be given to the parser will parse the string, and at the end it will tell whether the string has been accepted by the parser, or it will produce an error message and one error recovery routine will come to handle the situation. Okay, we shall use $ to mark the bottom of the stack and right end of the input. So that will be a $ symbol which will be found at the bottom of the stack. Initially that will be pushed and the input string will have this $ appended. So like this one, this is my stack where the $ has been pushed. So while doing the parsing, we'll be pushing other grammar symbols in the stack. So if we find that at the top of the stack we are finding $, that indicates that all other items, they have been popped off and the stack has got exhausted. It is remaining with the $ only. And this input string here, I have considered this one as W, and this $ has got appended. Appended means it has been added at the end. And when this particular input string will be parsed character by character, symbol by symbol, if it encounters with the $, that indicates that it has parsed the full input string. If parser detects an error, then it will stop stating unsuccessful for parsing. I told you earlier. But the parser detects following. If the parser detects following, that means if I'm getting $ at the bottom of the stack and above that only one non-terminal, that is the start symbol S, and the input string is having only $ left, then the parser halts and announces successful completion of parsing. So either the parser will state the input string has got accepted, or it will say an error, syntax error, has got generated. Now, primary actions of parser. Parser can perform four actions. One is the shift action, next one is the reduce action, accept action, and error action. In case of shift, the next input symbol to which my pointer is pointing will be shifted to the top of the stack. You know, we can insert only at the top of the stack. So, will be pushed and will be shifted to the top of the stack. That is a shift action. In case of reduce action, the parser detects the left end of the handle on the top of the stack and determines which non-terminal can replace it. That means the parser will check that up to which limit where it is getting one handle, and that handle will be popped from the stack and one non-terminal will be pushed on the top of the stack, depending upon the productions given in the grammar. We are going for the accept action. Here the parser announces the successful completion of the parsing. That means the string has got accepted and containing no syntax error. Parser discovers that a syntax error has occurred. In case of error action, the parser will detect the presence of an error, and that will be the syntax error, and calls an error recovery routine. So error recovery routine will come and that will handle the situation. So all the four actions we have discussed. What is the parser? What is the initial states? What is the final states? If the string has got accepted only then. So we have discussed everything. Now let us go for one example. So here, this is my example. So the production rules are E produces E plus E. You know, E means expression. So E produces E star E. E produces E within first brackets. And E produces ID. ID stands for identifier, that is variable. So now this is my shift and reduce parser. I've shown you what are the actions it is taking. What are the actions it is taking? And my input string is ID1 plus ID2 star ID3. You know, the $ should be appended at the end. So the $ is there. And initially the stack is having the $ at the bottom. Okay. Now here we have written not ID but ID1, ID2, ID3, only to numbering. So that you can detect or you can understand that which ID has been handled and taken care of. So now we are having this initial state for the stack, that is dollar at the bottom, and this is my input string, full string, and dollar has been appended. So the action will be shift. So ID1 has got shifted to the stacks. Shift means you are pushing that one on the top of the stack. So now the next action will be reduce by E produces ID. So I have got this handle at the top of the stack, only one grammar symbol, that is the ID, and this ID will be replaced by E, but in that case the input will remain intact. Now the next operation, next action will be shift. So plus has been shifted on the top of the stack. So now we are having this one remaining, plus has been shifted. So the next action will be shift. So ID2 has got shifted. So ID2 we didn't write here because it has got shifted on the top of the stack. And now the next action will be reduced by E produces ID. So E produces ID, the production rule number 4 will be triggered. So this ID2 will be replaced by E. Next action will be shift. So this star will be shifted. So I shall be remaining with ID3 dollar at this input section. So now the next action will be shift. So ID3 will be shifted. On the top of the stack, we are getting one handle. This is my handle, and this is the handle production rule. So this particular handle ID will be replaced by E. So ID has been replaced by E. So reduce by E produces ID. The next action will be reduce by E produces E star E. That means production rule number 2. So I'm getting E star E. I'm getting this E star E. So I have got the left end of my handle on the top of the stack, from the top of the stack. So it will be popped out and E will be pushed, because the left hand grammar symbol will be pushed after getting this handle on the top of the stack. So this is the handle production. So it will be pushed. Reduced by E produces E plus E. So ultimately I'm applying the first production rule. So E plus E will be replaced by E, and here it is telling accept. Why? Because if it has not been mentioned explicitly which is the starting symbol in a certain production set, production rules, then in that case obviously it is of a common practice, by default will be taking the first production rule, and the left hand side symbol non-terminal will be treated as a start symbol. So here we are having this E as the start symbol. So E, I'm finding this one at the top of the stack. Below that there will be the dollar, because dollar will not be popped off from the stack, it will remain as it is from the very first. And here my input string has got exhausted, all the input symbols we have read and parsed, and I'm remaining with this appended dollar which was there from the very initial. So as I'm getting this particular state, whatever we have discussed earlier, so the parser will announce the successful completion, and it will accept the string, because the string, input string, is not having any syntax error. In this way the things can be formed. And from here, when the shift reduce parser is working, how the respective parse tree can be constructed, I shall discuss that one in my next video. So that video will be in the continuation of this one. Please watch that one also, and thanks for watching this one.